Straight to the White House, the president taking questions about his acting chief of staff, Mick Mulvaney.
I've ever seen. We had a packed arena with thousands and thousands of people outside. It was an incredible evening. Got back very, very late. I did actually get to hear about Ambassador Kent. This is the witch hunt, you know, their crooked chief is coming after the Republican Party. He's coming after the Republican Party as hard as he can, considering he's really, he's been compromised very sadly and badly. Because of the fact, as you know, I think as the press knows, he made a statement and he made a virtual speech about what I said, and then it turned out that I didn't say any of it because he fraudulently made this statement to Congress. I thought what he did was one of the worst things. I understand he has immunity, but he doesn't have immunity when he puts it on his Twitter, which he did, and he doesn't have immunity when he speaks to press, which he did, and he certainly won't have immunity if we ever get him into Congress and can swear him under oath. Because what he did was a very bad thing. But what just happened is Ambassador Kent, who I have never had the privilege, I don't believe, of meeting. I don't know him. And they brought him in as a witness against me, even though I don't know him. And he excoriated, from what they reported on the news, and of course, maybe in this case it won't be fake news, but he excoriated the Obama administration and Joe Biden and Joe Biden's son, saying that he has tremendous problems with Joe Biden's son and the Ukraine. So he's got tremendous problems with Biden's son and Ukraine, and it's inappropriate, and all of the horrible things. I mean, you could get it, you could see it. It's been a big deal. And I heard Schiff is going, no, we don't want to talk about that. We don't want to talk about that. But he talked about it, and it's one of those things. Look, this is a terrible witch hunt. This is so bad for our country. I just spoke to President Erdogan of Turkey. We're doing very, very well with Turkey. There's a ceasefire or a pause or whatever you want to call it. There was some sniper fire this morning. There was mortar fire this morning that was eliminated quickly. And they're back to the full pause. We have ISIS totally under guard. Turkey is also guarding separately. They're watching over everything. So you have the Kurds who we're dealing with and are very happy about the way things are going, I must say. The Kurds, and you also have the Turks watching, just secondarily watching. So we have ISIS under control. We've taken control of the oil in the Middle East, the oil that we're talking about, the oil that everybody was worried about. We have, the U.S. has control of that. And there are no shots being fired. And a lot of people are doing a lot of things. This is a deal that should have been made 15 years ago, 10 years ago. Over the last number of years under the Obama administration, the real number is over 1 million people were killed. We have lost not a drop of blood since we've started what I've started. And it was, so far it's working out. Look, it's a complicated region. Many, many people have gone down. I have to watch in great interest as I see people talking about what we should be doing, and these are the same people that have been failing for the last 20 years, didn't know what they were doing, especially when they went in and did what they did. They shouldn't have been there. But we're doing a very, very significant amount of great work. We'll see if it works. It's very fragile. It's been fragile for years. They've been fighting each other for centuries. Literally for centuries they've been fighting each other. And years ago we injected ourselves right into the middle of it. And we won't go into whether or not that was a good thing or a bad thing. You know how I feel about it. But we've had tremendous success, I think, over the last couple of days. A little bit unconventional, a little bit of hard love, I told you that. It was a lot of pain for a couple of days. And sometimes you have to go through some pain before you can get a good solution. But the Kurds are very happy about it. President Erdogan in Turkey is satisfied with it, and we are in a very strong position. We are also in a position where we can put tremendous, powerful sanctions on Turkey or whoever else we want to. Our country is a financially much stronger country than when I took it over. China would have been, right now, the strongest economy in the world, the number one economy in the world. And right now, China is way behind us. We picked up trillions of dollars in value, in worth. And they've lost trillions and trillions of dollars, and they're having the worst year they've had in 57 years. With that being said, we're working with China very well. We've done, subject to getting it signed, and I think it will get signed quite easily, hopefully by the summit in Chile, where President Xi and I will both be. But a lot of good things are happening. Our farmers are taken care of. Our bankers and our financial services are going to have access, the likes of which they've never had, to the largest or second largest, depending on your definitions, about 1.4 billion people population, whether it's India or China. They're pretty close. And we've done some great things. So we had, but I just want to say, I want to thank the people of Dallas and the people of Fort Worth and the people of Texas, because yesterday was incredible. I want to thank Bernard Arnault, one of the great businessmen of the world, for agreeing to do something that was a first. He's built this incredible plant right in our great state of Texas, and they're going to make super luxury and super product. They have already started. It's opened, a big investment, and we're very proud of it. That was done with me and with the election, with even prior to the election, I said, you have to open up a plant someplace in the United States. He said, what do you think about Texas? I said, I love Texas. That would be good. And I said, if you do it, I'll be there. And so I fulfilled that commitment, but he opened up a beautiful plant. We think over 1,000 people will soon be working there. So thank you all very much. Yesterday was a big day. We had a great talk with President Erdogan, and it's going very well. Thank you very much.
Mr. President,
the president leaving the room at the White House there at the beginning of that, he said his chief of staff, Mick Mulvaney, had clarified